Operation Big Bang Theory is in effect. What it do, YouTube? It's your boy, Sixdogs1. And we're going to play with the sonotubes today. So first off, I'm going to show you guys how I measured and cut them to get as straight a cut as I could around the edges. So let's start off there. All right, as you can see, I've got the two sawhorses here. And what I did was I've got some clamps. And I put the clamps on the sawhorses. That'll keep it from rolling on me. So it doesn't roll while I'm cutting. All right, so I've got my tape here. Oh, this, by the way, you can see my bands have gotten kind of dirty since I've been working on this morning. But a screw went right through the palm of my hand. It was a stupid mistake on my part. So, oops, it's sore as hell, but I'm going to try and work through it. Anyway, we've got the measuring tape here. As you can see, we've got a nice factory cut. We'll just measure this to, let's say, 18 inches. All right, we're going to take the tape locked. All right. There we go. All right, we want to make sure it's nice and straight. Going along here. And you come here to your 18 inches. And you just mark it. All right, there's one 18 inches, and then you roll it over. As you can see, there's our mark here. Then you just measure again. Go over about 4 inches. Measure again. Make sure it's straight. And then come here and mark your 18 inches. Okay, and you do that all the way around it. Well, then what I do, I take... Where is it at? Where's my tape? There it is. Whoop, yep. There's a sonotube. I'll talk to you more about it in a minute. Alright. So we're going to take our nice tape here. Alright, you come here to the first mark and you tape it. You get that nice and lined up with your mark. And then you come along and you come over to your second mark. As you can see, there's our second mark. So you just come along and you bring the tape and line it up with that second mark. And then you just do the same thing all the way around. You find your mark, you line up the tape with that mark. By the time you get back around, you could have a perfect 18-inch length of sonotube. Then you just take your jigsaw and you just cut right along the tape. And that's how I cut mine. So that's a quick explanation of exactly how I did it. I hope it might have been a little confusing, but I hope that helped a little bit. As you can see, we have got the sonotube cut. We've got the inside in there. I've already poured some fiberglass down in there. There's already a gallon in this baby. And we're gonna start a little bit more. It should just take another maybe quarter of a gallon, maybe, to fill it all the way up. So it takes about a gallon and a quarter or so. It's done. Let me go show you what I'm doing. Now this is going to be the whole concept. These are actually going to be dynamite sticks. And I wanted to look as authentic as possible. So what I did was I had it nice and smooth, but it was a little too smooth and fake looking. So what I did was I took the butt of a screwdriver and just kind of lightly hit it around, you know, all in a bunch of different little places, just to show some little nicks. And then also what I did was I took the sandpaper, and after I had glassed over everything, I took the sandpaper and sanded it in a couple spots, like along this here where you can actually see the little crease there. I sanded along that just so to give it that nice, authentic dynamite stick look. But that's one end of it with an arrow port in it. This is just a really, really thin layer of paint here, and there is going to be another layer of paint on there. And all those little dings and stuff should show through after I paint it. So you'll see the whole concept. It's going to be pretty sick. Alright, we've got our resin here. We will be doing 2 cups at a time. 2 cups, which is 16 ounces. And for every ounce of hardener, you want to do 10 drops of activator. So altogether with 2 cups, 16 ounces, we will be doing 160 drops in every 2 cups of resin. So that's how we're going to do it, and we're going to get to mixing. So let's get on it. Not too sure how good you can see that, but starting to fill up. It should take just a very, very little bit more. Not even probably a cup full of these up, so get back with you. All right, now that we have got the compartments filled up with fiberglass, I'm gonna pour some glue on top. See, we're putting plenty of glue on that baby. And this is gonna be the trick. It's gonna be getting this circle in here. So, let's see. All right, now we're just screwing screws in the top just to sink these two pieces together. There we go, those two should be synced together really good. We're gonna caulk around the edges, and then we're gonna flip it upside down to make sure that this bottom gets sealed just like the other one. All right, as you can see here, we've got it all caulked up and ready to go. Of course, there's gonna be some sanding to get these edges even. All right, we've got our sanding tube flipped upside down, so just give it time. We'll let that dry, and it's starting to get a little warm. Yep, looking good, sounding solid as ever. All right, YouTube, it's the second day of Operation Big Bang Theory. As you can see, we've got one of the dynamite sticks here ready to go. Wanted to give it a little bit of a rougher look just so it would look like an authentic, like a real dynamite stick. So as you can see, I didn't do as much sanding up on like the top area because that's going to be seen out the back, so I want that to look a little bit rugged. All this has been sanded down nice and smooth, so that one's done. That's going to be one dynamite stick there. So we've got the other that we were doing yesterday. Just let it dry overnight. Get nice and hard. Yep, I think that'll do it. Yes, that one is filled and ready for a little bit of resin. So we're going to do that today. As you can see, we've torn the mag completely apart. We got all kind of shit everywhere right now. Yep. And the headliner is about to come out. A, B, and C pillars are about to come out. So, yeah, buddy. Yeah, we're gonna start ripping everything out and just start doing a bunch of shit, painting shit, and just, you know, we're just going wild with this one. So, like I say, ripped everything apart here, all the panels here, Mom and Pop's crib. So they'll be staying here for a couple days in the garage. All right, well, I guess that's it for this little bit of this video. Guess who's back up in the building? Mine on the million. It's some bitch from the case. She be holding my case. And I be holding her down. She be holding my word. And I be dicking her down. Just got a call from the other side of town. See, trying to come up the opposite of down. Just hope he ain't the feds, nigga. I'ma do me. Said he coming right back. He gon' need another three. Two plays, four birds, one nigga, who wins? 17-5. Yeah, they know, shout it out.